Today's guest is a successful businessman turned filmmaker who is using cinema to bring stories of redemption and newfound purpose to his native home of Paraguay and to audiences across the United States. Please welcome Marcelo Torcida. Welcome, bienvenido.
Gracias. Proud to be here.
Vamos a continuar en inglés. Con permiso.
Bueno.
So you have an extremely interesting history before you were a filmmaker. You did many other things. Can you tell us a little bit about your background?
Yes, I was a swimmer in Olympic category. Mm-hmm. I married very, very fast at 21 years old, and I became an entrepreneur. Mm-hmm. I learned about insurance, and I be incorporate in Paraguay crop insurance, and I did many other things, by the way. I made a factory, a shoe factory, making more than 1,000 pairs a day.
Wow.
After exporting a little bit of medicinal herbs as well, organics, but still always with the insurance, which was my first love. So now I became a filmmaker.
That's amazing. So you've covered lots of different business areas. You were a businessman in several different areas. How did that lead, or how did you discover the need to make the film Happy Those Who Cry? How did you become the filmmaker that you've become now?
Okay, I am always try to be creative, even in business, in the way to commercialize. I don't want to be always the same or to do always the same thing. Try to reinvent me in the way to many things. So I feel better in this way. Sometimes it's the wrong side of this is that sometimes I became a little bit tired, especially now that I am becoming older, but I like to learn. So become a filmmaker was not the same motivation than the others, but a spiritual one.
Mm-hmm. Tell us how you discovered the story of your film or the origin of your film.
Okay, I really, let's say, suffer
for
15, 20 years. Many things that today I'm knowing, like panic disorder, mm-hmm. or something like that, that before were not diagnosis for this and not medicamentous. Mm-hmm. So I try to deal with this, even working and so, and try to play, to imagine better moments in the moment that I was suffering this kind of attacks that could happen during a meeting, a business meeting, or during flights over the sea or whatever. But so I tried to fly with my mind, and so I developed a kind of magic. After I reach the flotation level, in the sense, okay, I can again enjoy the life and everything, mm-hmm. I look forward and I said, how many people around the world may pass through this kind of proofs during their life? So why not to be to testimony what happens to me and just comment to the other people that there is a light at the end of the tunnel?
Uh-huh.
So it started. I start beginning to think in a movie script, and suddenly I was convinced by this, and the purpose was to share this story with the people that will appreciate it. Yes.
And then, why did you choose specifically film, the medium of film, as a way to tell this story that you were discovering?
In reality, I started to think with a book, because I am I like to read a lot. Mm-hmm. But in all South America, at least, the people doesn't read too much. So they are more glued or attached to the TV or audiovisual programs. So I fastening moved to audiovisual because I wanted to reach as most people as possible, because the original message I want to pass. So I think in a script. I never had an idea how to write a script. So I look for assistance, and okay, I was very well assisted.
Let's watch a short trailer from your film. And then, which is called Felices los que lloran, or Happy Those Who Cry. And then after we watch the trailer, we'll talk a little bit more about how you got started making
this. Okay, of
course. Okay, let's watch.
Este tema va dedicado a todas las personas que se sienten acosadas en su vida.
¿Por qué no agarras los libros? O te pones a trabajar si quieres.
Estoy podrido que la gente me diga lo que tengo que hacer siempre.
¿Te acordás de Ricardo? Su hijo ha desaparecido.
Si se muere, es tu culpa.
No seas necio. Estos tipos te van a hacer pedazos.
Te vas a tu casa y te encerras. ¿Mm? Y no salís hasta que yo diga.
Vos sabés algo más y no me querés contar.
Me importa tres carajos los inocentes.
Nada de armas.
En que mi hijo se vaya.
¡Cosa!
¡Ayuda! ¡Ayuda!
¿Ves lo que yo veo?
Very, very beautiful images and words in that short clip. And there's clearly a spiritual dimension, a religious dimension even, in that film. Can you talk about that aspect, that layer of the film?
Sure. I wasn't a religious man. I wasn't just like everyone, in the sense that, okay, I was baptized in the Catholic Church, and I received the communion, and I married by the rites, the Catholic rites. But suddenly I start my life in common with my wife and paying attention to my children. And so we go away about all the practices. And so, but okay, I was focusing and motivating by the world and all the social inputs the society are saying and insisting to you, be successful, mm-hmm. Be rich, mm-hmm. be funny, be good friend, be good man, and so on. Be perfect in one word. So I realized, or I didn't realize, and I buy all the stuff in the sense that, okay, I wanted to be all of them. And after some decades living, I get what I want in my job. I had certain quantity of money. I have four children. I have a marriage, happy, and so. But in my very deep of the soul, I wasn't happy. Mm. If I was in London, I was to be in Rio. If I was in Rio, I want to be in my home, and so on. And anything satisfy me, and just trying to jump higher and higher and higher. And every time I reach or achieve the goal, suddenly it remains nothing, so always getting worse. At that point, I almost was like that draw inside, mm-hmm. and I was very unhappy. I began to have insomnia, and every time more, till I arrived, even with medicine, till 22 days without sleeping.
22 days?
Yes, with I don't desire to anybody. Really is a very ugly feeling, seeing that all the city go sleep and wake up and go sleep and wake up, all the process. So I noticed that I stopped to have this normal and natural process in my life, just focusing in results, any kind of the results. So I suddenly become, I feeling like literally sick, like drunk every day. So I even doesn't touch a drop of beer or whatever alcoholic, because I felt like drunk every day and trying to focus on work and so. The night 22 in my home without sleeping, and so that was really desperating. I went to the entry in front of my door, where a Bible was laid in that place for decades. without even reading one word or
never
so.
Opened.
But I lay in the floor, and I open my hands like you can see in the trailer, and I just desperately mention in my mind, okay, whatever you want and what you do you want, I will do that. But please help me, and really I was helped. And in a way that it remains not doubt that I was helped, but by a spiritual force. So I start to change my point of view of life. I give the value what it really has, and I put away all the things I count. So I used to say that I am the same dirty sock, but somebody put the hand inside and give me to the other side
inside
of the
out.
Soul,
yes,
inside out.
Yes. Uh-huh.
So, and I look as new, completely clean. But
yeah, you do.
Yes. Thank you. And I start to feel really comfortable with this, that I was living all the things that really doesn't matter in your life. So just conserve the friendship, the relation with the human beings, and so on. So after I stabilized my life, or they stabilized, they said they is a spiritual force, for me it's God. And I really enjoy life. And one day, I wake me up, and I think, okay, I must in some way help all the people that maybe are passing with the same situation.
And that's what led you to make
and
the,
that's why
the story.
I made the story.
Yeah.
Yes.
So how much? I mean, the conversion, if you will, from not only the dark night of the soul to this transformation, but also from a life in business, in major business enterprises, to the very different world of filmmaking. How much did you know before you started about film? Anything? Did you have to?
I want to add that because I was a swimmer and very competitive, I doesn't look colleagues. I looked like enemies. So I was focusing all day how to beat them, not to relate with them. So and I noticed this so much in many other branches in the life, businesses or others. So I really let's just can reach out and can remain in almost 6 years. Mm-hmm. So my recommendation is be patient. It's not suddenly, because I start to some of 7 days of the week you start to feel one day gorgeous and you really enjoy. So it really goes slow, and in 6 years, okay, I really know everything, and in the sense that, okay, not this path, not this other way.
Did you write down the story first and show it to a director or a producer, or how did that first origin story become this beautiful film?
And in reality, 90% of what happens in the film is true, but not linearly.
Okay.
So I took some things from friends with his permission, of course, from my parents, from people who I know really, and all the dialogues are really the same dialogues. It happens, and which I was in the middle of the situation, and so the idea really was built in 2 months. Mm. Why? Because I used to go for a walk or for a little bit of running, and during the running I was putting or somebody else are adding points or things that complete this history. When I complete the history, I flew to Buenos Aires in Argentina. I met the writer because I had no idea. And after talk a couple of days, she said, no, you have all the history perfectly defined, so you will write, and I will help you with the structure of the script. And so we did.
And where was the film made? Where was it shot and produced?
Okay, in Paraguay, we have a very tiny industry. It's starting right now. Just to give an idea, my movie is the seventh in the whole Paraguayan history.
Wow, fantastic.
Yes, so it's the seventh feature in the whole history. They made, okay, we have televisions and we have some shorts and they made some documentaries as well, but feature films are not made really. So I tried to get some technicians and I brought some from Argentina and from Spain who helped me. And it's important to remark that I want not direct the movie. I prepared that one friend of mine will be the director, but because he saw so many inconveniences, so a lack of industry in there, he quit.
Okay.
But
became the director.
And so, because I had a sense of mission, mm-hmm. so it was not just to tell a story. It's a mission that's tell the story for this reason,
yeah.
or for that people. So I put the jacket of director jacket and I did it.
And not only did you put the jacket on, but you won a big award as best director for this film, and also the best feature film at the beautiful name here, the Mirabile Dictu, which means a miraculous saying, right? Something like that.
Is this Marvelous to Relate?
Marvelous to Relate.
Yes.
The International Catholic Film Festival, where I think I heard that you met the Pope.
Yes.
Is that
indeed,
true?
Yes, indeed. I met him three times.
How was that? I have to just ask, how was that?
I saw two popes directly. Mm-hmm. John Paul II, mm-hmm. which is saint now. He was brilliant in the sense, literally. It seems that I like a neon light inside, and, mm-hmm. and he writes. Mm-hmm. And this one is in another way, the same thing. Just passing the hand and I start to cry. Mm. And I can explain that after the talk we had, just to mention a brief talk, the first time I was with my wife. And my wife said, Paul, we today, because it was our anniversary in that moment, will be 27 years married. And he blinked me an eye and said, and I need to congratulate you because your effort
right.
to me and joking to my wife. So and he laughed suddenly and continued to do jokes. After he remembers that asked to his first job boss in his life in Argentina was a Paraguayan woman, which he comments this to us and congratulates my wife just to be a Paraguayan woman because according his opinion, the Paraguayan women are glorious.
Oh, wonderful. What a great story.
Yes,
and again, congratulations on the prize, too. Let's not forget that.
I
want to show a quick trailer that you made about your desire to make a difference in Paraguay by bringing film and culture to the people of Paraguay. This is a very interesting, it's very short, but we'll watch it and then we'll just take a quick moment about it afterwards. Okay, let's watch.
Hi, my name is Marcelo Torcida. I am from Paraguay, a country with no more than 7 million people. Here in the heart of South America, we produce food for more than 35 million people all around the world. That is to say, 28 million more than the one who live here. Unfortunately, such prosperity does not show in the inhabitants' lifestyle, given the poor distribution of wealth and the lack of cultural places to stimulate the creativity of those who do not have access to the few cultural centers we have. To give an example, 96.8% of Paraguayan population has never been to a cinema. That's why our challenge is to improve educational and cultural level of the less advantaged, so that one day soon everybody will have the same opportunities. We will display a film which talks about values, hope, and above all, the idea that we all have the opportunity of doing something good with our lives. With that in mind, we acquire mobile cinema equipment to tour all Paraguayan territory, especially those areas with less resources and possibilities. A motivational and fun film which will let them know that no matter what our current situation is, each and every one of us matters as a human being. Help us to bring hope to those who have been forgotten.
help us to put a smile on the less advantaged. We count on you.
What a great project. How far along, how close are you to achieving that goal of bringing cinema to the people of Paraguay?
We now have everything, the movie, the equipments, and but we still have, I am looking for the sponsors, mm-hmm. because the idea is to arrive for free. There are many people that doesn't afford or can't afford, and we can, the experience be lived by the whole family. We try to recover this focus. So let's hope the sponsors appear.
Yeah, exactly. Maybe someone's watching right now.
Yes.
Buena suerte.
Gracias.
We have questions from our studio audience here. Who has the first question? Yes.
I was wondering how your business skills help you to distribute and create your film.
Yes, of course. I as an insurer, I deal with a lot of industries. Paraguay is a small country still, so we don't have big specializations areas. So you must do sometimes much better. As I used to said, you must shoot the ball, be the keeper, and throw catch the ball. So one-man show. And for this reason, we develop usually in Paraguay many skills at the same time, except the experts of or physicians, medicians, but it really helps, yes, definitely.
Terrific. Do we have another question? Yes, sir.
The question is there a certain set of responsibilities that comes along with being a filmmaker of faith?
Of course. It's a very big responsibility, and I thank you very much for that that question, because I really do the film in order to touch the soul of the people. The modern society is forgetting that we are body and soul, and just put attention and focus on the body, which, okay, is an important vehicle here on Earth, but the reality of us, the feeling, the your love comes from your soul. So we need to care about the soul. Without a balance, almost you will die.
Great, thank you. Another question from our students. Do I see one? Yes.
Was it difficult to revisit certain aspects of your life during the creation of this film?
Really, no, because during those 6 years I passed reviewing my life. Till I have to review many things. Every one of us must a little bit review and recheck our facts, our things, as many as time as possible, because otherwise to come back or to address will be different. It's like a small tree. Well, you plant a small tree, if you don't go in directing, you will lose the right way to grow. So many of our mistakes are I always said, nobody, I or just few quantity people of the world wake up in the morning and said, today I will be really a bad man. It doesn't happen normally. But it happens. So and my point of view is that because the people doesn't review it. And if the most important thing at this point is honesty, but honesty with yourself. Many times we do things that we are not happy to do, or we take shortcuts in life, to put a name, that leads to another part that are inconvenient. Otherwise, at times we pretend or intend to escape through drugs, for instance, and escape from situations that we must focus in and try to resolve without, as possible, this kind of hurts.
Great. Another question.
Did your vision for the film turn out the way you wanted to?
Again, please, because my English is not too good.
Did your vision for the film turn out the way you wanted it to?
No. I had in my head so many things I want to reflect on this. And I was limited because our industry is limited as well in down in Paraguay. So I am a little thirsty for a second film, and in a more developed environment to try to improve that. It doesn't mean that the film doesn't touch the heart, but just to, because it's a spiritual thing, I want to put all I can, all the best, because otherwise I will put as a thing that doesn't matter too much.
You clearly have a sense of mission and a sense of purpose in the film itself and in the project of bringing cinema to the people of Paraguay. What kinds of changes do you want to see happen in your country? What kind of progress are you trying to see, are you trying to make?
I was surprised in the sense of, okay, I know that I can finish one film considerably well done, but I am surprising the way is or the how is arriving to some place like here, for instance, mm-hmm. and how is an a new universal message that I put in there, or without maybe the complete willing in there was something that I said providential. How do you explain that somebody who never write a movie script, never direct, and never post-pro, and all the process, and after this become a or obtain an award? It I am sure it is not me. So I said this many things is providential. That's why the question: may you see what I see, because I today see many things that before, at least me, I can't see, because I was too focused on world, on economy, on diary things, and I never stopped just to stay quiet and to put a little bit of silence in my mind. And in silence, you can hear your conscience.
Yes.
And your conscience would talk.
In that silence, is there another film taking shape? Do you know if there's...
Already.
And where will you make it? Here or in Paraguay?
I have in mind, I want to invite some people of here. My challenge again, because I want to do things that really challenge, is to invite students to help me.
Well, you've come to the right place.
Yes, I guess.
We're out of time, but thank you so much for being here.
Thanks to you.
UA.
Thank you very much. Thanks to you all.